guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be making another fun art and craft. So this includes outdoors and indoors both combined. I'm going to be making a craft of campfire. It's going to be a whole project kind of thing and it's very beautiful. I think you guys are going to love it and it's a little hard to make if you don't follow the instructions, but it's nice and easy to make if you do follow the instructions. So before we start, we have to tell you that what we need. So let's start. We're going to be needing a 30 centimeter or 15 centimeter scale, rubber band, a napkin, paints, water, needle, three small cardboard pieces, it should be square, a white cardboard base, it has to be big, one thin brush, one thick brush, one pen, a cloth, scissors, tape, toothpick, and a small box of cardboard that's made out of thin cardboard. Then, yeah, that's it. And of course, and a bowl of water and toothpicks. And under all this, you have to keep a newspaper so it doesn't get dirty. So let's start. First, I'm going to be taking my cardboard base. And I'm going to be making a river like this. So I am done using it. I've made a river. It's supposed to be a curvy line. Now we're going to be making our campfire. I'm very excited for this. I love to make campfires. It's very nice. So the things we're going to be needing to make the campfire are these. We'll be using some tape. Our trusty old tape. So yeah, I've made my river and as I told you, it's time to make the campfire. So we're going to be needing our trusty old tape, the rubber band, the three cardboard pieces, the three pencils, the cloth, and the scissors. So let's start. Now, we're going to be making the base of our campfire. Campfire, like this. I'm gonna make it into a triangle like this, and then I'm gonna quickly take the third stick and stick it like this. This is how it's supposed to look. Then I'm gonna use tape to stick it into place. See, on the top part I'm gonna stick it like this. Now when we stretch it, it looks, and then we're gonna be putting our cloth like this later. First we need to make the base because it can't stay still like this forever. So we're gonna be making our base by the three cardboard pieces. I'm gonna show you a quick trick how to make double-sided tape after a single tape. So this is a sticky part and this is a non-sticky part. I'm going to take the sticky part and fold it here, and a little part that's remaining I'm also going to fold it on and overlap it. And this is an all-sided tape and I'm going to stick it on my base and put one of my pencils here like that. Then we still need to provide it with a little more tape. How we're going to do that? I'm taking a big piece of tape and taping it like so. Yeah, so I have all stuck this and we're going to do the same on the other two sides. So let's do that. Take a piece of tape, fold. I'm going to be repeating the process and I'm going to be telling you also how to. I mean, you already know, but if you don't remember the process, you can always play the video back or you can just watch me do this two more times like that. This process may take 2 minutes, but then we're done with the hard part. It's not hard part, it's normal part, say that. And we just have to put the tape on it, I mean cloth, and then we will be done. So I'm also going to be trying it without that double-sided tape part, but I don't think it's going to work like that, but you know, I'm trying it anyways. Okay, so it kind of worked, kind of not, I'm not really. So yeah, I've stretched it now, time to put the cloth on it. Now, you don't want to cover the whole thing because you're going to need a little bit space also for the people to get in, even though we know there are going to be new people during this pandemic, of course. So we have to see on how it covers it, and if you can't do it properly, first stretch the pencil and then put it like this. There's going to be a middle part which you can put it on, and then the top part you can tie with a rubber band like this, or if you want you can leave it without the rubber band as well, but I'm gonna go with it. But only on the very top part you are supposed to tie it, because it should not affect these down parts. Now, how we're gonna stick the base is so it stays still, and also put some tape on it like this. So that's very easy to do, right? This stuff was easy. So yeah, we're gonna do the same thing and rip it. So I am done. I've stuck on every side so it doesn't come out. And yeah. And guys, so when I was doing it, this one, which I have not stuck the all-sided tape on, came off. So do remember to put the all-sided tape. Otherwise, it will come out. Now, time for my favorite part, painting. Let's start. So first, I'm going to take the green. It's really hard to open this. Yeah, I'm going to use a cleric paints because I love the cleric paints. And I have an emergency palette right here of paints, just in case it goes out, because we're gonna be painting like a lot. So let's start. Wait, I forgot to dip my brush in water. How can I forget that? It's one of the most painful parts. It's very easy to paint if you have a thick brush. This is where the thick brush comes in to be using. And you can make extra paint by dipping a little water, putting, and then boom, you don't even need to like put your brush on it. Now be very careful when you're near the river, because you don't want any green going on the river, because we want blue there, right? Not green. Or you can also do one quick thing, put a little paint here so it's very easy to do. So yeah, I'm gonna add now paint. Ooh, look at this view. I love green because it represents nature, and I love nature, but I also love fire. I love everything. Like, who doesn't love everything? Now be very careful because you don't want it going on wherever you're painting. I could have put in a newspaper right now, but I really need to finish this quickly. So yeah, I'm going to be painting here and here, and I'm going to be seeing you in 5 minutes.